We ain't come here to play.
We came here to eat.
Yeah. Coming to Woodside, Queens, we're in this restaurant, Kabayan.
Kabayan, yeah.
Yeah.
I think you need to get your own dish on the menu.
Right.
When we're done.
We talk about blackness in a monolithic way as if it's one experience.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not, you know, even myself being mixed. Where did you learn to find yourself and be comfortable with yourself and embrace your blackness, clearly, and embrace being Filipino?
I mean, I was always like kind of sure of myself, pretty confident, but there were always those moments where I felt like, okay, I'm too Filipino for the black kids. I'm too black for the Filipino kids. I got all these different perspectives of life and I kind of formed my own. And there's a bunch of women who need somebody to look up to that is not a certain mold, you know, that believes that there is no mold
right. For
what a woman should be, or what an artist should be, or what a black woman should be, or a black artist should be.
What was your experience like, you know, growing up in the Bay?
I love the Bay Area. I love where I'm from, the authenticity of it, and there's a sense of community there. So I always felt like I had a good foundation, a good support system.
What music was playing in the house?
Oh my gosh, everything. A lot of old school. My mom loves ballads. Filipinos love ballads. They love Whitney Houston. They love Mariah Carey. You know, they love Alicia Keys. I feel like I did feel something from Whitney singing. I was inspired to sing because of a Whitney, you know? And I was inspired to perform a certain way because she paved the way. My dad, he listened to a lot of Prince. He was everything. He was rock, he was blues, he was pop, he was R&B. It was just magic to me.
I feel like we're letting this food go to waste. It's getting a little bit cold.
It's time to dig in.
We could definitely just like eat and talk. Cause okay. I think you said it's tradition to bond over food, right?
Number one, finger food, lumpia. You gotta try that.
Okay.
Here, boom, cheers.
love. And what's this called again?
Lumpia. It's like the
best. Where have you been all my life?
It's the best spring roll you've ever had in your life.
Did your mom make this in the crib?
All the time. Actually, that's how my parents met. My dad would come home from work and she would offer to cook for him. They lived across the hall from each other in an apartment complex.
You got me. That's love at first.
At first bite.
Yeah, love at first bite. There you go.
We got crispy pasta, which is pork, pinakbit, tilapia, tocino.
I love this food. I want to know how to cook some of it. So can we go back with Chef Joe and he's going to show us how to make some of these dishes? You probably already know, but I need the education.
I need it too, to be honest with you. Let's do it.
Chef Joe, thanks for having us.
Yeah. Right. Let's do this.
When, you know, your mom and your grandmother used to cook, was it special occasions, like holidays? Was it like
It was
Sundays,
every other day.
Every other
they
day.
Was cooking a lot, yeah.
Just come in here and be like, just order the H.E.R. That's it.
Right.
Yeah, they really putting us to work, man.
Facts.
I was watching you at the Grammys perform sometimes, and it felt like, okay. There's another chamber. There's something else that we've been missing.
Mm-hmm.
What was the inspiration for that one?
You know, it was crazy with Kobe's passing and on the day of the Grammys, how fitting the message was. You can't always plan, you know, life. You just gotta be positive and just go with it sometimes. And that's what the song is about. It's just like, it's really hard, but I know I have to trust.
When you come off from the piano, pull out the guitar, you put your leg up and just start going and shredding on the guitar. It really made me think about the young black girls and boys that you may inspire that may not know Prince, but may know H.E.R. and may know that Grammy moment. The influence that you might have on the younger generation, does that ever dawn on you?
I was just making what was honest to me. You know, I just knew what I loved. I released my project, Volume 1, in 2016. And people started to say like, wow, she's speaking my life, you know? Oh, I've felt this before. And at first I was like, surprised, like, oh, really? Eventually it was just like, wow, okay, I am a voice for young women or for anybody who's felt this way. It's still kind of surreal and I still have those moments of like, wow, you know, what other artists did for me, I'm doing for people. and to be a young Black woman who is able to unleash that power and to be able to impact other young Black women, especially to pick up a guitar. I just feel grateful and blessed, you know, to be that kind of influence.
What type of audience do you attract when you're out there?
Oh my gosh, can I tell you a story? It's very mixed. I just did this festival in Las Vegas. There's 2 days, and on the first day, it was a lot more Black artists, right? And I was on the second day. Right. And at first, I was kind of like, oh, why wasn't I on the day with like the more R&B folks? I did the show, and I was like, wait a minute, these people know the words to my songs, and they love my music. At that moment, I realized I put myself in that box. Like, why did you think that you were not prepared for this second day when my goal was to be a prince who appeals to everybody? And it was one of the best shows I ever had.
How are we doing, Chef Joe?
How you doing, man?
We're doing it now. It's already
filling.
What am I doing?
Mix it now.
Just mix it up?
Yeah.
Okay. I want to go into the birth of H.E.R. Sitting here with you, like, you're an open book with your feelings and your emotions, and especially in your music, so the acronym of having everything revealed. I think on the surface it was mysterious, but you just open up. Mm. What was that thought that made you want to maybe pull a veil?
I remember when I was making all this music, having a hard time like being honest, and everybody in my life kind of seeing me as this little girl prodigy, you know, the little girl, right? Mm-hmm. And always feeling like I had to, you know, live up to a certain expectation. It's hard to be honest. It's like, are people gonna like the music, first of all? And are they going to accept the message? I didn't want anybody to know how old I was or, you know, what I looked like. I wanted to get back to music being the forefront. Mm-hmm. And when I released Volume 1, I said, okay, I want the cover to be just a silhouette. And that's all you get. And then I did it, and everybody was like, who is this? Who is she? I think it's so-and-so. That was the idea of just the birth of making music the forefront and people paying attention to that, focusing on that.
Chef Joe with the pop.
Look at that. That looks legit.
I made this. I did this in.
Oh,
this is
okay.
All me. Okay. You know, you talked about being scared initially and having this fear of being honest. Mm-hmm. Have those fears been alleviated? Do you feel like you can be more honest in your music?
Absolutely.
Okay.
I feel like I have a responsibility to be at this point because so many women have came to me and said, you make me comfortable being myself. Just as Black artists get put in a box, women get put in a box to be a certain way, to look a certain way, especially artists.
We did that. Mm. It's delicious.
Wow, I can smell the peanut butter.
Finished product. I can't wait to eat this. This kare-kare looks delicious.
This is the best seller in me.
Yes. It wouldn't be a Filipino meal without steamed rice on the
side.
It's
awesome rice, okay. Chef Joe, thank you so much for allowing us in your kitchen and to cook with you, man.
Like, yeah. Man, we killed it. I mean, you did your thing on the C-Sig, on the pork ear.
Yeah. I got it in my eye.
Got the pork adobo. I did my thing on that. Yeah. And I think we both did our thing on the kare-kare.
The kare-kare, for real.
Peanut butter. Mmm, so good. Salamat, Chef Joe.
Salamat din.
Outside of music, the Bay Area is the birthplace of the Black Panther movement.
Mm-hmm.
How did that influence you?
It's kind of crazy to think about. Like, thinking that was the center of it all. People from the Bay just naturally have this confidence about themselves, and that's really what, you know, the Black Panther movement was about. It was about, like, being Black and being proud. Be a leader, understand what's going on, and change it. Do something about it. That's kind of the influence it had on me, as far as just being proud and confident in who I am, and that I knew anywhere I went, I could be myself.
I feel like every project you peel back a layer, we learn a little something more about you.
Yep.
And even sonically, you explore different things. Again, opening up that box of what we're talking about.
Yeah.
Like, you know, it's not just R&B.
No.
It's funk, it's soul. If you could kind of describe the evolution of your discography,
yeah,
that's H.E.R.
That was the perfect explanation, but thank you. It's really just been evolution of self. Like, it's been evolution of me and who I am, who I'm becoming as a woman. I think you really hear that in the music. This upcoming project is definitely going to be reminiscent of the first two projects sonically, but elevated because it's gonna be much more musical. It's going to be opened up.
So, you know, finally, I wanna talk about legacy. If someone were to Google search you in 10 years, what do you hope to find?
Man, I mean, so much has happened in the last 2 years. I don't even know what by that point, right, what's going to be found. Like, to be honest with you, before I released Volume 1, I created a vision board, and I've pretty much covered majority of the things on that vision board. At the end of the day, all those big accomplishments, little people around the world can say, oh my gosh, this song changed my life. This song helped me get through this. I don't think I've even fulfilled my full purpose. Mm-hmm. I'm here to do multiple things and I've only just begun. I'm only 22 years old. So, you know, sky's the limit.
Grammy Award winning 22-year-old H.E.R. Like, you know, was that on the vision board? Was the Grammy Award on the vision board?
It was nominated and, right, and winning, yes. And I got two.
Yeah.
Nah. And 10 nominations in 2 years. So right, who knows what's gonna happen. You know, it's just about impact. It's about just being myself and not being afraid of living up to any expectation but my own. And telling any other artist or any woman, black woman, whoever, that's the only expectation you have to live up to is your own.
H.E.R., thank you so much for sitting with us.
Thank you.
For talking, for sharing this food, and hopefully we have this time again soon.
I'm sure we will.
As for all the times your grandmother kicked you out of the kitchen.
Exactly.
Yeah.